Hi, and welcome to Cinex Movies. Bullet Train is a 2022 American action comedy film about Ladybug, an assassin whose latest mission puts him at conflict with several other adversaries unbeknownst to him on a Japanese bullet train. The movie begins in a hospital in Tokyo, where Yuichi Kimura, aka the father, is agonizing and sobbing over his son, Wataru, who is lying unconscious on the hospital bed. Meanwhile, on the television in the room, news has it that the Boomslang, an extremely dangerous snake, had been stolen from the zoo the previous night. Yuichi's father, aka the elder, walks in and inquires about the welfare of his grandson. On hearing that there is no change yet, he rebukes Yuichi for his negligence, stating that it is a father's duty to protect his family. He queries where Wataru's father was when Wataru was pushed off the roof of a story building. Now, in the city of Tokyo, there is an assassin whose new operational name is Ladybug, according to his handler, Maria Beetle. He is onto her on the phone, and she quickly thanks him for taking the job in spite of the short notice. He claims to be in the best shape and state of mind possible, and quickly reels out a list of jobs that have gone quite well and easy for him, perhaps as a testament to how luck has been on his side in recent times. It turns out he's filling in for Carver, another assassin, who is reportedly having some abdominal trouble, much to Ladybug's displeasure when Maria informs him. On arrival at his locker in the train station, Ladybug finds out he misplaced his key when he and Yuichi bumped into each other earlier. Maria is, however, on hand to tell him the unlocking code, after which he collects the items he needs for the operation, including his sleeping powder, but leaving behind the gun, despite Maria's counsel. He rushes onto the train after Yuichi gets on the same train. While on board the train, Maria runs Ladybug through a quick description of the train and how the trip would progress. Meanwhile, Lemon and Tangerine, another set of assassins, are also aboard the train and are having some back and forth. Still over the phone, Maria explains that Ladybug's target is a briefcase with a train sticker on its handle. As he proceeds, it later turns out he had also misplaced his boarding ticket when he and Yuichi bumped into each other. He is, however, allowed to check in when he presents his receipt, on the condition that he will deboard at the first station. Yuichi has a note directing him to a particular seat in the first class car. Whoever sent the note claimed they were responsible for pushing his son, Wataru. Gun in hand, he arrives at the spot, only to find an innocent-looking young girl. He will find out soon how not so innocent she is when she knocks him out with a taser. Apparently, she had been awaiting his arrival. Lemon and Tangerine are having another of their backs and forth, while Ladybug figures the briefcase he is meant to steal must contain money. He finds the case rather easily, and Maria's instruction is that he gets off the train. In the meantime, a young man in Lemon and Tangerine's custody wakes up. He happens to be one of the two assets they had been hired to deliver, the other being the briefcase Ladybug is stealing. Lemon goes on and on about Thomas the Tank Engine, a children TV show he obviously loves, and one from which he had learned so much, including relating people he meets to characters in the show. Lemon and Tangerine soon get into another needless argument, this time around over the number of people they killed while trying to get their man out of trouble. They literally go through each kill they made one after the other. The young man seems uninterested in all of it and simply wants to leave. But, to drive home the gravity of their task, Tangerine narrates the gory story of how the young man's father, known as the White Death, had chopped off a woman's hand because she repaid his money 5 minutes late. In the meantime, Ladybug is making his way to another end of the train. But he is nervous, he feels the mission is proceeding far too easily. Just about then, Tangerine has Lemon go get the case he had stashed, the very same case Ladybug was making away with. After confirming to his caller that he and Lemon have both White Death's son and the case, Tangerine receives an order to deboard at Kyoto Station. Unfortunately, the case is now nowhere to be found. It soon happens that Ladybug runs out of luck, as he is stopped by an old foe just as he is about to deboard the train. Yuichi regains consciousness. He is now being held hostage by the young girl named Little Prince by her parents. She has a man at the hospital where Yuichi's son Wataru is lying unconscious, and she orders the man to kill Wataru if he does not hear from her. For the avoidance of doubt, Tangerine runs Lemon through the story of the White Death's becoming. He had newly come to Japan from Russia, worked his way up the ranks in Minegishi's gang, and being the leader of the underworld who placed so much value on tradition and loyalty, Minegishi soon made him one of his most trusted allies against incessant warnings by his associates. The White Death would eventually stab Minegishi in the back, killing him and building his own empire. Now, being the head of the largest criminal organization in the world, his wife, who was the most important thing in his life, had died in a supposed drunk driving accident. Tangerine further explains that the White Death did not actually hire two random operators. Rather, he had in fact hired those who were responsible for a job in Bolivia who made mincemeat of his own men, and whom he considered the best hands to get back his son. Elsewhere in the moving train, Little Prince explained to Yuichi how she had trailed him to a location where he delivered a briefcase to one of the White Death's associates 2 days earlier. It was then that she decided he was the perfect man to carry out her mission, to kill the White Death. Lemon and Tangerine set out to find whoever stole the briefcase. However, in an unfortunate turn of events, they find the White Death's son dead in his seat, having bled out through his eyes. I end a flashback to 26 years earlier. The wolf, who had attacked Ladybug, was a little boy whose mother sent off away from the house to fend for himself. He grew into a ferocious man whose wife was killed at his own wedding. Someone had poisoned the wedding cake, and the wolf's newly wedded wife, along with every guest in attendance, bled to death, including his boss, El Saguaro. On his revenge mission, he boards the train at the Shinagawa station where he attacks Ladybug as he is about to deboard with the briefcase. In the middle of their heated duel, the wolf vows to ruin Ladybug's life as Ladybug ruined his, but Ladybug does not even seem to recognize him. Ladybug is able to repel him well enough, and in a stroke of sheer luck shining on him, the wolf throws a knife at him, which ricochets off the briefcase Ladybug is still clutching and returns straight back to pierce the wolf's chest, killing him instantly. Ladybug sets up the wolf's body on a seat in a way to make it look like he is only asleep. Lemon and Tangerine do the same to the body of the White Death's son. Then, Tangerine sends off Lemon to find and kill whoever has the briefcase. The train makes another stop at the Shin Yokohama station, and Ladybug spots Lemon brandishing a gun as he is about to deboard the train. He recognizes him as the guy from a job in Johannesburg, and quickly hides himself. Unfortunately, he runs into someone wearing the attire of an anime character and misses his stop. He reports the situation to Maria, who tells him to hide the case and deboard at the next station. She also helps him identify the wolf as the guy whose wedding he infiltrated in Mexico while disguising as the cocktail server. While on the phone with Maria, Ladybug spots Tangerine walking towards him from the next car and quickly hides. From his hiding, he watches Tangerine smartly dismiss his handler's queries into why he stepped out of the train and rings off. Tangerine spots Ladybug but has no reason to suspect him. However, on his inquiry into whether she or Yuichi had seen anyone with a silver briefcase, he gets a description from Little Prince that matches the very same man he had just spotted and walked away from Ladybug. Tangerine alerts Lemon, who is on the other end of the train, as he himself makes his way there. However, it is a little late because Ladybug finds Lemon first and threatens him into cooperation with a little mind game. Ladybug lets Lemon know it was he, Lemon, who shot at him in Johannesburg. Little Prince finds the briefcase where Ladybug stashed it, and Lemon soon figures out Ladybug's ruse, and they both get into a fight. Ladybug does well to knock Lemon out and then spike his water with some sleeping powder. He uses Lemon's phone to report everything to Maria, how Tangerine and Lemon were meant to safekeep the White Death's son, but now someone had killed him the same way El Saguaro and the wolf's wife were killed. Just then, Ladybug accidentally sets free the Boomslang, the same dangerous snake that had been declared stolen from the zoo that morning. Tangerine finds Lemon knocked out. Ladybug escapes him with help from another guy on board whom he had paid off. Meanwhile, Little Prince gets Yuichi to unlock the case so she can rig it with explosives just as she did with the gun in Yuichi's hands, all in order to kill the White Death. Tangerine and Lemon manage to keep up their ruse, then they both set out again to find Ladybug, who had managed to elude them both. While hiding in a toilet, Maria reminds Ladybug of a certain surgeon who had died in the middle of performing a heart surgery. Contrary to the official cover of a stroke, the surgeon had in fact been poisoned by an assassin named Hornet with Boomslang venom that congeals the blood, making one bleed to death from every orifice unless the antidote is administered within 30 minutes. And now, it appeared the Hornet, who had disguised as the pastry chef at the wolf's wedding, was on that train, disguising this time as an anime character, and was in fact behind the killing of the White Death's son. Before Ladybug can set out to find the case, Tangerine finds him first using a tracking signal from Lemon's phone, which Ladybug had stolen. It's a heated fight all over again, but Tangerine has to answer a call from his handler. Things are now more complicated as the White Death wants them all out of the train at the next stop or everyone on the train dies. Ladybug poses with Tangerine at the stop as Lemon, but he overdoes his thing trying to sell the deception, blows the cover, and they both have to jump back on the train. Ladybug soon has to kick Tangerine off the train at another stop while Lemon finds Yuichi and Little Prince and quickly figures something must be off. In a bid to save his son, Yuichi falsely admits that he is the bad guy and Lemon shoots him. Tangerine struggles but eventually succeeds in getting back on the train. However, Lemon figures out Little Prince is the villain, but the effect of the sleeping powder in his water soon kicks in and he passes out, allowing Little Prince to shoot him with his own gun and stash both he and Yuichi in a toilet. Elsewhere, Ladybug discovers who the Hornet is and a duel ensues. After Ladybug gets a little jab from the poison, he injects the Hornet with a larger part of her own poison and then snatches the antivenom from her and injects himself with it. Tangerine finds Lemon knocked out and takes him for dead. The White Death finally calls Tangerine and promises to wreak nothing short of havoc, but Tangerine responds rather defiantly in the wake of Lemon's supposed death. Tangerine crosses paths with the Little Prince once again. this time he notices a sticker Lemon had placed on her and knows she's far from innocent. But before he can make his move, Ladybug comes along and shoots him in the neck before he has time to explain things. Ladybug falls for Little Prince's antics, and she tricks him into staying on the train. In an interesting development, Yuichi's father, aka the Elder, boards the train, sits close to Ladybug and Little Prince, and quickly recognizes Little Prince as the lady whose voice he had heard while speaking with Yuichi over the phone, and as the person who pushed his grandson off the roof of a store. As Ladybug reaches for the rigged gun in Little Prince's bag, the boomslang strikes and fastens itself to his hand. While he is away getting the snake off him, the Elder confronts Little Prince, demanding to know why she harmed his grandson. She explains rather unconcernedly how she did that to get Yuichi to kill the White Death for her, and how Yuichi's son would soon be dead, as was Yuichi. But she is mistaken, as the Elder already had someone take out her henchmen at the hospital, and Yuichi was still very much alive. On Ladybug's return after Little Prince's departure, the Elder warns him that the young girl is not all that she seems to be. He goes further to narrate the story of how he had been Minegishi's right-hand man until the White Death came along, and how the White Death had taken everything from him except his son, Yuichi. He considered this a final opportunity to make things right when the White Death arrives on the train. The Elder and Ladybug find Lemon and Yuichi. Lemon, who had been lucky to have had his bulletproof vest on when Little Prince shot him, finally wakes up and finds Tangerine's body elsewhere on the train. A fight nearly breaks out between Lemon, Ladybug, and Yuichi as they trade blames on one another. However, the Elder intervenes, talking them back to their senses and getting everyone to work together as a team. After much ado, the White Death finally gets on the train, and the first person he meets is Little Prince, who turns out to be his daughter. He, however, does not fall for her manipulation to pull the trigger on the rigged gun. Ladybug hands over the briefcase as a distraction, and the White Death admits to him that it was he who hired all the assassins and got them on the train, hoping they would kill one another. He further explains to Ladybug how his wife's death was actually an assassination attempt on him, and how his wife headed on the operation table after the only surgeon that could save her was killed with snake poison by an assassin. Then, he had hired the same assassin, the Hornet, to kill his own son, because it was while on her way to get him out of one of his frequent troubles that she was killed. So, he had hired Carver, whom Ladybug was filling in for so he could kill him. However, the White Death's henchmen open the rigged case, and the explosion creates enough distraction for Ladybug to escape. The Elder and his son, Yuichi, take out more of the White Death's men just as Lemon is able to get the train moving. The White Death and the Elder finally meet and get into a sword fight, but Lemon is unable to stop the train, and so he hands over to Ladybug while he takes on the other bad guys. Lemon and Ladybug both apologize to each other, and just as one of the gunmen is about to shoot Ladybug, Lemon plunges into him and they both plummet down into a river below. Coming at no better a time, Ladybug finally finds a way to apply the brakes, which sends the other henchmen off the train and White Death a mortal blow with the help of his son. Ladybug is a little late, as the train crashes into a settlement before the brakes can bring it to a complete halt. The White Death is bent on killing Ladybug, even after he explains he is not Carver. He pulls the trigger on Little Prince's rigged gun and blows off his own head in the process. The Little Prince somehow finds her way to the scene, wielding a machine gun. But Lemon is on hand to run her over with a tangerine truck. Maria comes along for Ladybug, who is overwhelmed with emotions. It's later revealed how Lemon had survived the fall into the river, taken out his attacker, and hijacked the tangerine truck with which he ran Little Prince over, perhaps avenging Tangerine's death. Thank you for your time. Kindly like and subscribe.